Hello friends, this is James. Today I would like to show you how to use Excel Solver to generate a production schedule for a department or a factory. Before I demonstrate how the solver works, let me explain the detail of this schedule to you. What you see here is a production schedule for the lead department. Just for example, the start date of the schedule is 21st of December. At the right-hand side of this schedule are the production information, such as the work order number, the products to be made, the production quantity, and the due date for this department. The standard minutes are the time needed to make a piece of product. The loading is actually the production quantity multiplied by the standard minutes. I then convert it to hours. These two columns are the work center reference and the work center number. The WC reference is just a simple sequence. The Excel solver finds the best work center for this order by changing this reference number. Why we also have the work center code here? It's because in most cases, we do not use simple number for the work center. It is usually an alphanumeric code. In this Excel, I use VLOOKUP to find the work center code. I have defined 20 work centers for this demo. This is the OEE of the work centers. OEE stands for Overall Equipment Effectiveness. You may call it efficiency. This Excel worksheet finds the work center and its OEE based on the work center reference. This column is telling you whether or not this order has enough time to make if a work center is assigned to it. For example, this order, it may need more 34 hours to complete it. Then it is red in color. The next column are the start date and finish date of the orders. These gray areas are cells with formula defined, therefore you should not edit or change them. Up here are two cells for the solver to set its objective. You can only choose either one for the objective cell. The lower one is the number of orders may overdue. The upper one is the total hour overdue. We will tell the solver to minimize them. Right here is telling you how many work centers has been chosen. Let's look at the right-hand side of the schedule. This is a Gantt chart. The top row is the work hour of each day. This is the day in day month format. This is December 21st, December 22nd. These color bars represent an order from start production to finished production, such as this one, start from 27th of December and completed on 8th of January. The gray columns are on working day, and thus the work hours are zero. The number in each cell is telling you the possible daily output. All these are calculated automatically. After the schedule has been generated, if an order may overdue, the finish date will be red in color. Before we go into the sofa, I would like to show you how these days are calculated. Actually, I have to define a work calendar in this worksheet so that we know when it is work day and when it is not. The first day of the calendar should always point to the scheduled start day. Then it will generate the rest of the days in the year. It will also define the weekday. You can input the number of work hours here if you want it, 9 hours per day. Just input here. I have set all Sunday to non-working days, so load it to define one by one. You can also define holiday here. Just define month and day of the holiday, then you can create some common public holidays such as Christmas and New Year. Okay, finally we can see how the sofa works. I get to erase all the old orders first. You see the cells have formula defined or become errors. Then I need to get my new orders. Suppose you have your IT department or production department to provide you the orders in Excel format. Then just copy and paste here. Now the orders are sorted by the production due date from nearest to longest. Since low work center has assigned, the formula cells are still error. Let's assume the scheduled start date still 21st of December. Now we can activate the solver program. Bear in mind, you should always use the solver in the data menu, not the third party one in add-on. It is not work in this case. I have already defined the solver conditions. First, set the objective cell. I choose the number of orders overdue. I want to minimize this number. How to do it? I tell the solver the variable cells are the work center reference. If it keep change them until find the best solution, it must be some constraints. We only need 3 constraints here. Since we have 20 work centers, the variables must be between 1 and 20. For Excel solver, we need 2 constraints to define the between conditions, less or equal to, and greater or equal to. The third constraint is the variable must be integer. 3 constraints are enough in our case. You must choose the evolutionary solving method because our problem is not a linear program or linear problem. That's an option to set. Maximum time without improvement. It is to tell the solver when to stop if it cannot find any further improvement. The default value is 30, but it is too soon to stop in our case, since we have a lot of combination of work orders and work centers. We better make it bigger. I set to 200. Beware this range. They must cover all your orders in the schedule. Now, click solve to let the solver run. You can see the numbers here are increasing. It is normal. If the numbers change very slow, then it must be something wrong. The subproblems here, in our case, it may increase up to over 10,000. Now you see the number in the objective cell is dropping. That means it is trying to minimize the overdue and find the best solution. since it may take some time to run. Let's get back later.
Okay, the chauffeur has stopped. This time it almost takes 10 minutes to find the best solution. Let's look at the result. It displays a message. Chauffeur cannot improve the current solution. All constraints are satisfied. It is okay as long as all constraints are satisfied. By default, it keeps chauffeur solution. Then we click OK to keep the solution. Now, you see low order will be overdue. Even not a minute to overdue. But only need 19 work centers to work. It may be the loading is not big enough. Next time I should put more orders on the schedule. You may notice the Gantt chart behave abnormal. All orders are started on 21st of December. It is fine as we still need one more step. We need to sort the orders to make it reasonable. We sort the orders by work center first, then by start day. Now the Gantt chart become reasonable. You see, work center A01 work this order. Work center A04 work this order first and will finish on 24th of December. Then it work on next order. It also calculate the output by the time remaining on this day.
So it is done.
You can download this Excel template on my website. Try it yourself and change it to fit your own situation. I also made some tutorial on YouTube to show you how to make this schedule from scratch. If you like this video, please give me a like and subscribe. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.